What is up, you guys? Welcome back to our channel. Today I'm super excited because we're reviewing another new product from the drugstore. Today we're reviewing the new Revlon Photoready Candid Collection by Revlon, which I'm super excited. They did send me the foundation, the concealer, and also their setting powder. So they are definitely like bringing it on this year, you guys. I'm gonna be testing it out for you, everything on my face, of course. First, let's get into the packaging and everything about this little collection. First off, let's start with the foundation, which I'm pretty sure you guys are excited about. The foundation comes in 31 shade, which I think is a pretty awesome range for drugstore. This is a natural finish foundation and it's anti-pollution. I'm not sure what that's supposed to mean, but I'll leave it somewhere in the description in case you guys are interested. This is the shade that I'm using today. 350 Natural Tan is the shade that like matched me best. And I gotta say right off the bat, this foundation does oxidize, at least for me. I'm gonna show you guys, of course, everything, how it oxidized, how dark it gets, blah blah, all that. First off, this is the foundation. It's in a little tube. This is the packaging, the tube, and also has a pump, which I'm not mad about because it's a very nice size. It's a pretty good size to carry around. It doesn't take much space, which I really like because, you know, most of us don't have like huge makeup storage. Majority of us have like very small makeup storage, so I definitely love that this doesn't take too much space. So once again, this does comes in 31 different shades, and the foundation, you guys, retail for $10.99. I don't think it's a bad price, but let's be honest, drugstore prices are definitely have gone up since our time. But anyways, moving on, I'm gonna go ahead and swatch it for you guys, the three different shades that I received, so you guys can see the colors, of course. But the one that matched me best was the 350. Regardless, they also sent me the shade 410, and this is how it swatched. This is the color, and they also sent me the shade 420. So those are the three shades of foundation right there. Pretty weird range. So I do definitely love how dark it goes, like as you can see, but the dark range is not as much, sadly. Anyways, moving on. Okay, you guys, so I'm gonna do one side primer and the other side no primer whatsoever to see the difference of this foundation. Okay, I definitely don't like this brush because with every foundation that I use, I feel like this brush takes away like the whole foundation. So I'm just gonna do it again. I actually use one of my favorite brush foundations. For this, I'm gonna pump a little bit more and just blend it in with this. Okay, this is so much better, yes. It has a really nice finish, you guys. The foundation does state that it's a natural finish and it's anti-pollution. You're getting both of both worlds. It blended in really nice, you guys. I'm not having any problems with it. It looks really good. I don't feel like it dries up really quickly, so that's nice. And again, this is the side with no primer on, but one side is no primer and the other side is with primer. Yo, they look pretty f-ing flawless, you guys. Like, both sides look really freaking good. Damn, it does look super dewy, you guys, which I don't mind because I do have dry skin, so I really like that. But let's see if we can also mattify it. And then, you guys, I do this with all my foundation, then I like to press it in with my beauty blender. So I'm just gonna do that like I normally would do with my foundations. Wow, this sets really nice. It has like a satin finish, you guys, like not matte and not oily, just like really there in between. But it's so crazy how both sides look exactly the same with primer and with no primer. It's mind-blowing to me right now, like wow. And I actually like this color on my skin, by the way, is the shade 420, and this is a sun beige shade. I really really like how it looks. So far so good.
2,000 years later.
Next, you guys, we're gonna try their concealer, and this is the shade medium 040. As you can see, I'm hoping that this won't be too dark, and it does has a doe-foot applicator like this one. Ooh, I like this doe-foot applicator. It's so nice, you guys. It's definitely so different because, let me show you, I hope you guys can see that, but the tip of it is, it comes like a little wider than the rest of the applicator. That's pretty awesome, and it feels so nice when you apply it too. But I love the way it's shaped. The tip of the applicator is very like wider than the rest of the doe-foot applicator, which is really nice. I love how it applied. Let's go ahead and show you guys how it goes on the skin. Okay, you guys, the concealer looks absolutely amazing. Like, it looks so flawless. Everything is looking really good right now. I just want to test this out and see how long it will last on my face, but so far, so good. Nothing is like settling into any fine lines. Nothing here as well. Like, everything looks pointless. Everything looks so flawless. I'm freaking loving this, okay? It's a-okay. Wow, the drugstore is really stepping it up. Like, holy shit. I almost feel like, because due to my face being dry, I feel like I don't need any like mattifying or anything like that because it looks so good right now. But they do came out with 3 different shades of their translucent powder, and these are the Photo Ready Anti-Pollution Setting Powder, and I have the shade 001. So it looks like this. I'm gonna go ahead and open it. It's just like a regular, you know, the same regular packaging of every... Oh, matter of fact, this is a little different because it has this little top right here which you pulled up, and then you have the powder down here, like that. Okay, so I got a bit of my sponge and I'm gonna go ahead and set my under eyes, even though I feel like I don't need to, but let's just go ahead and apply this. Ooh, that looks really nice. And for the powder, you guys, they do come in 3 different translucent shades and they retail for $9.99. and I didn't tell you about the concealer. I'm sorry, the concealer does come in 17 different shades. So now that you hear almost everything about the foundation, if I leave anything out, you guys, please leave it in the comments. I would love to answer you. You guys know I love to talk to you, so don't worry. Leave it in the comments if you have any questions and I'll answer right away.
2,000 years later.
You guys, my foundation looks still pretty freaking good. It's been a few hours now, like 3 hours, and I'm outside. So I just want to check in so you guys can see everything looks good. You guys, so just checking in so you guys can see my foundation. Oh, should let me not copyright, honey. So you guys can see my foundation, it still looks freaking awesome. Even though it's been a few hours only, like maybe 3-4 hours, but it still looks pretty good. Like, it's still intact, nothing is moving around. It's bad lighting here, so I'm sorry. Anyway, guys, this is all I have for you today. So this is basically the collection, you guys. Oh, and I almost forgot to tell you that they did send me two of their brushes that they will be launching in 2019. These are their brush collection, Live Boldly, that are coming in 2019. This is what they said on this little card right here. They look pretty amazing, and they actually look super high-end. They don't even look like drugstore brushes anymore, which is crazy. This is a powder brush, and this is a foundation brush. So I'm super excited, definitely, for what's coming on 2019 for every freaking brand. So yeah, you guys, I hope you enjoy my little demo review on this, on the new Photo Ready Candid Collection by Revlon. I love drugstore, you guys know that, so I'm super excited about everything. So yeah, let me know in the comments down below if you guys will be picking this up, if you guys are interested on that or what.